Hello and welcome students in RKIS English class. Today we will discuss format of letter. Have a look at the board. Letter writing is an art. Basically or broadly, letters can be divided into two types. You can divide letters into two types: informal letters, informal letters. Informal letters are generally written to the relatives. On the other hand, second type, formal letters. Formal letters are written to heads of various departments, editors of newspaper, principal and managers, etc. Formal letters can further divide into They can be divided into complaint letters. Complaint letters are generally written to the heads of different department. Suppose if you are complaining regarding law and the problem of law and order in your area, then you will address the letter the SHO of your area. Okay, complaint letter, inquiry letter. Placing order, etc. In this way, you can divide formal letters in various types like complaint letter, inquiry letter, or placing order, etc. Sometimes some application made for the job also. Now we will discuss format of the letter. Have a look. It is extremely important to follow the format. So have a look. First of all, on the left hand side corner of the page, first of all you will write here sender's address, and there can be 2, 3 or sometimes 4 parts of the sender's address, and you will use one line to write one part. So separate line for separate part, I mean to say. So senders is who is senders? Writer. So you will write here the writer's address. Try to write this in 2 or 3 lines at least. Then after writing sender's address, leave some space blank. Keep in mind, leave some space blank, and then you will write date. Suppose 13th May 2020. Keep in mind, the year must be preceded by comma. Put comma just before the year or just after the date, you can say. After writing date, you will write sender's address on the left hand side of the page. Then you, after leaving some space, you will write the date in this way. Then again you will leave a line blank. Keep in mind, you will again leave a line blank. Then you will write receiver's address here. You will write the receiver's address just like the sender's address in different lines. You can use 2, 3 lines for this. So then again you will leave a line blank. Then again you will leave a line blank. After this, you will write subject. Subject, no need to put an arrow. your subject must be brief and to the point. You can underline the subject also. It must be brief. Then we are coming to discuss body of the letter. After this, body of the letter. After this, look here, body of the letter or content, you can say body of the letter or content can be divided. Content or body of the letter can be divided into three paragraphs. In first paragraph, you will address the status or the issue. Then in second paragraph, there will be analysis of the issue and reasons. In second paragraph, you will discuss analysis of the issue or the status with reasons. In paragraph 3, you will give suggestion or action required. You will take care of the paragraphs very properly. Then, just one thing I forgot to tell you. One thing, before the body of the letter, one very important thing is you will write salutation. It should be very formal. It must not be personal, right? You can write sir or madam. No need to put comma after the salutation, after the word sir or madam. Sometime you can write Mr. or Mrs., but after writing Mr. or Mrs., you have to write full name. Mr. A.K. Agarwal. You have to write full name. So make it very clear again. First of all, you will write sender's year. You will leave a line blank. Then you will write date. After leaving a line blank, you will write receiver's address in different lines. After leaving a line blank, you will write subject in brief. Then you will write salutation. Then body of the letter. And you can divide body of the letter in three different paragraphs. Paragraph 1, 2, 3. And in first paragraph, you will describe the status or the issue. In second paragraph, you will analyze the reason. Analysis of the reason will be there. And part 3, suggestion or action required. After this, complimentary clause. Next part is complimentary clause, like yours, faithfully, or yours, sincerely. This will be the complimentary clause. After writing complimentary clause, you will put your signature. Then after signing the letter, you will write your name. Sometime you can write your capacity or post. So after this, student, in some kind of letters, or we can say applications, etc., sometime in complaint letter also, you can write one more thing, that is after leaving 2-3 line blank, you can add one more point, that is enclosure. If you are enclosing any page with the letter, then you will write here enclosure, and your photocopy of this, that, etc., you will write the enclosures here. They can be 1, 2 or more sometime. That's all for the day, students.